Mac Bako is a sports managing editor at dailynational.com, and he's joining us from New York. Mike, before I get to the big decision from FIFA regarding 2026, tell me about all this drama with the Spanish team and their coach for this year's World Cup. He was fired one day after agreeing to take on another job?
Absolutely. This is a pretty stunning development for one of the favorites in the World Cup. As you mentioned, the Spanish team has fired their national coach. The national coach just a day ago accepted an invitation to become the Real Madrid head coach, one of the premier soccer teams and franchises in the entire world. They were not informed of this decision, so they took punitive action against this coach. He is out as their international coach. Someone will be replacing him. But on the eve of the World Cup, this is a stunning development for a team that has really high hopes.
Well, let's talk about this year's World Cup. For the first time, I'm sorry, the 2026 World Cup, rather. For the first time, it will be hosted by three countries in North America. How significant is this? And did it really come down to money and profits?
It came down to money, profits, and it also came down to infrastructure. If you look at this bid from the U.S., certainly hosting the majority of the games, Mexico and Canada, you're talking about an infrastructure not only of money, but of stadiums. If right now they took the World Cup and said, we're not playing it in Russia, we're playing it in the U.S., the U.S. has enough infrastructure and enough stadiums, from soccer stadiums to football stadiums, that they could transform into soccer stadiums, that they could host the games right now. So what you're looking at is this trend of organizations looking at host cities. You see it in the Olympics. Los Angeles was accepted as one of the host cities in the coming years because they have very little construction to do. There's some infrastructure that they need to do, but they don't need to do what Russia has been doing. They certainly don't need to do what Saudi Arabia has to do for the 2022 Cup. And one of the shortcomings of the Moroccan bid is just how much infrastructure and how much lack of confidence they had in the fact that they'd be able to build up all of these stadiums, hotel accommodations, and all of the other things that come along with hosting such a huge international event.
From what I understand, this is not the first time there have been joint bids, but they were rejected in the past. So why do you think they were accepted this time around with these three countries in North America?
I think you see the strength of the bid for one thing. You know, from the U.S. Hosting the World Cup final or proposing to host it at the stadium here in New York, that's a huge international audience. I think certainly bringing in two soccer-rich areas like Canada and Mexico. You mentioned how fervent the soccer desire is in Mexico. They haven't hosted the game since 1986. Canada has never hosted it. And certainly here in the U.S., we hosted in 1994. So I think they just looked at it as infrastructure, money, and growing a fan base that in this North America area has really grown and will continue to grow as we head towards that 2026 World Cup date.
All right, Mike Bako. Thank you so much.